so strong. Yeah, see, I trust this love I'm feeling, because it makes me wanna sing. Woo! There's no question where it's going. There ain't no question where it's been. You see, it's always been here with me and will be here till the end. Because I trust this love I'm feeling.
Love so good. the Twin Cities Jazz Fest. So Pippi Ardennia is here to tell us more about PIPJAZZ and about her travels from Chicago to Minnesota.
Oh, thank you very much. Well, you know, I came here about 5.5 years ago just so I could get away from Chicago and to actually to write music. I was commissioned to do music for 2 years and for my new CD. And I completed that, but the whole time I was just amazed at the culture that was here in Minnesota. And so the Twin Cities was so exciting and so much more manageable than Chicago. And I loved it because it had art, you have the music, you have, theater. It was just amazing. So I decided I wanted to stay instead of going back. I completed my mission of writing my new CD, and I decided to move to one of the Twin Cities, and I chose St. Paul. And since then, I've created PIPJAZZ Sundays.
Pippi Ardennia is here with us. She's a jazz vocalist, she's a writer, she's a composer. Now she's a St. Paul booster as well. She says she lives right across the street from Mears Park. So she came over to imbibe some blues herself. Excuse me, some jazz. Of course, as you know, I'm a blues lady, so blues is always foremost in my mind. But blues and jazz has a very fine line. And Pippi agrees with me. We're going to talk with her more about PIPJAZZ and the Walker West Music Academy.
Oh, my God, the Walker West Music Academy, such a wonderful history, such great people there. The students are just so alive and just ready to learn. It's such an exciting place, and I was there for a while teaching I called it a program that I created was Feel the Music program for the little students. And they would close their eyes and feel the music, and then I would have them to draw what the music was about. Well, I wanted to transfer all of this energy that's here because the students here are so well educated in the music and in arts. So I decided to find a home, which was over here at the Landmark Center in St. Paul, and to have a showcase. And most places, this is the only place that I perform, and have these amazing young students to come on stage with us. They are referred to us by Walker West Music Academy and Twin City Jazz Society's educational department. And they find these great students, and we feature them with guest artists, with a world-class band on stage in an audience, in a concert setting, where they can experience and grow like they've never done before. It's amazing. It's amazing transformation to see what happens to these students.
I think it's an amazing transformation to see you when you talk about jazz. You can tell, can't you, camera? Look at her. She just lights up. Jazz is more than just a medium for your expression, isn't it? For you, jazz is something else.
Jazz is freedom to me. Oh, it's the ability to express yourself in a way that you can't find any other way. It's spiritual. And so you just fly, and blues is right there too. That's why I call it PIPJAZZ, because PIPJAZZ is music that makes you feel. So I have had Barbara LeSure on, I have all these great musicians, you know, Patty Peterson, and they just come on stage and they're just electric and alive, and I'm electric and alive, and then the band is electric and alive, and then the students are electric and alive, and then the audience just gets electric and alive. It's a way sound makes you fly.
Jackie Maddox for the Twin Cities Jazz Fest, joined by the man behind the production, Cactus Productions. Joining me, Ron Kinnebrew, or we call him the Cactus Man. What was your thoughts in putting this thing together today?
Well, Jackie, first of all, I want to thank everybody for watching the show and coming out here to the Twin Cities Jazz Fest, and that we have such a beautiful draw out here. This is incredible. I've been covering this event for 4 years, and this year I was so fortunate enough to make it a bigger production and have very fine people working with me on this, and from the director all the way down. And I'm just so glad, even my host right here, Miss Maddox, who has a radio show for many years, and that you were willing to come and lend your voice and your talent to this production. I'm really...
Well, tell us more about jam and jazz. It's the sessions, is that what you're calling it?
Yes,
jam
yes.
And jazz sessions?
Yes.
Is that because you go around the Twin Cities and you get jam and jazz sessions from the different clubs around town, as well as open outdoor festivals like this.
Yes, that is true. Let's just right now focus on the jazz, because that's what it's all about.
So it seems to me like jazz is your heart. Is that true?
Yes, it is.